play all day, and they've played from behind. And that's amazed me, but it happens quite often, and it's unlucky for them that it happened on such an important occasion. Full credit to Collingwood, who have been given the whip over the last few weeks now, coming right back and winning the right to play Melbourne. Schofield, the hook shot, and it's home. Thought 80,000 people could be so quiet. The cheer they're making is for Harry Sullivan, who has just come off the ground, allowing Bob Greave on. Sullivan has played wonderfully for Collingwood again today. That mark was taken by Reeves against Eastmuir. And the man who has replaced Leryl Sharp as Collingwood's back pocket is playing very well. He kicks towards Fellows, and height must win out. He was against Stevenson, and the 6'6" boy for Collingwood marks it well and kicks to the half-forward line. Beers in there, still going strong for Collingwood. He's given a nice elbow by Teasdale. The ball is handball to English, who's been out of form for North today, and English kicks to the wing, and Stevenson takes the mark. Fellows drops it. Harrison punches it to Merritt. Merritt comes back through the pack. He's on the member's wing, and with a right foot kick, his pass is as accurate as with his left foot, and he finds Turner. Turner, a bad kick for him. To the half-forward line, English with the ball. Passes it to Aylett in the centre. Aylett nicely turns around Gray, and his kick from centre half-forward is going in towards the sticks. Didn't get the right bounce to take it through. Peter Lucas helped it through to save the day. 14-12 to 6 goals, 15. The stands have thinned out a good deal. It's Peter Lucas playing fullback, and he kicks out. Was taken by Peter Schofield. He kicked 6 goals against Collingwood last time, but only 1 today, and you saw that goal. He kicks it in towards the sticks, and Brian Martin has a shot for goal, and he couldn't miss it from there, and it's home. Pretty hard for a team once it's kicked 2 goals in quick succession still to find itself 7 goals behind. That's the situation here with 22 minutes of the final quarter already played. Another Melbourne and Collingwood grand final it will be. Torpedo punt is to Fife of North Melbourne, between the centre and halfback line for his side. How many changes Collingwood will make for its side next week. Likely to make very few in view of the team's excellent performance today. Although the brand of football has been far from good, You can't ask any more of a team in a preliminary final than to win by 7 goals, and let this Collingwood side, rearranged as it is, has done. Schofield kicking for goal, it's screwing away, but it gets the bounce in towards the sticks. And that's Peter Lucas running it through the behind post. Kingston was telling me earlier that he is doubtful to be fit. Neville Waller's injury is still not right, evidently, and Captain Frank Tuck is very doubtful as to whether he'll be able to play. Brady, North Melbourne's captain, he has played at centre-half forward and centre-half back today. That's his hand pass to Aylett from 40 yards out. Aylett kicks a torpedo, or a punt on a torpedo, and it's through. 14 goals to 8. The official bench just inside the fence for Sid Coventry, Gordon Hocking, Hans Kine, and Frank Tuck, quite unperturbed. McMahon, 32 is Waddington, both of North Melbourne. The bounce-up is still in the centre of the ground. Sarong, Waddington. Waddington's kick is to Mantello. Mantello kicks it right down there to within 30 yards of the goal. Aylett. Hook shot here, and a through. By scoring, Mick Aylett. Has kicked 2 goals for North Melbourne, Dugdale 3 and Schofield 2, and 1 each to Doolan and Mark. For Collingwood, 4 to Brewer and 3 to Wiedemann, 2 to Merritt and 1 each to Turner, Bennett, Fellows, Smale and Sarong. They must have charged the North Melbourne team with some Ampol Super under the half forward line. Brady at centre half forward, and if he kicks better than the general run of kicks today on this ground, he is one of the players who could easily put this through from here. It's a punt kick, he didn't time it too well, and it's falling just short. Reeves handballs nicely to Rose, and is smartly felled as he does handball it. By 3 North Melbourne forwards, and Reeves gets his free kick. Although they found some new method in their play, method which they have shown in recent weeks, it's come a little late for North Melbourne, and time is right against them. This is Gray in the centre of the ground, putting Collingwood into attack to the scoreboard goal. Smale's mark. The umpire won't allow it and says play on. Smale pulled down by Edwards. Wiedemann's kick for goal. And it's into the goal square. Over the back. Taken by Cale. And Cale, who is playing in defence instead of in attack as usual with the North Melbourne team, kicks the ball to the half-back line, where it is out of bounds. And is thrown right out by Thorold Merritt, who did not agree with the boundary umpire's decision. Martin palms it to Gray, the Collingwood man. His kick is right to the forward line. Good play in defence by North. Teasdale's kick is to the half-forward flank. This mark is taken by Bill Sarong. Or if I'm mistaken, him with Ken Turner again, I have it. Long focus shots make them quite similar in their bare arms and their build, although Sarong is a much taller player. That's Sarong out there now, kicking the ball along to the half-forward line for his side. Eastmuir balls to McMahon. McMahon's kick is to Mantello, and Mantello quickly plays on to Stevenson in the pocket, and Stevenson will play on too. His kick is towards Aylett. Dugdale has it, but Aylett has given a free kick for around the neck. North Melbourne fans are getting very vocal now, but I wonder, do they know the time? How much have we had? 28 and a half minutes. They're still 5 goals behind. Melbourne have piled on the goals over the last 10 minutes.